to Thailand then, and three people have been wounded after gunshots and explosions at a standoff between pro and anti-government protesters in Bangkok. Opposition supporters are threatening to derail tomorrow's elections over alleged vote buying and corruption. Sky reporter Sarah Un is in Bangkok for us. Sarah, what is the latest from there?
Yeah, hello. Yes, well, there has indeed, as you've just said, been quite a major gun battle about 10 kilometres north of me up near the government complex, which has been a centre of confrontation for a couple of months now. Apparently, there had been a tent standoff all day. Anti-government protesters were trying to stop any ballot boxes getting into a polling station up there. Pro-government protesters came down to try to push them out of the way. Unarmed police were trying to negotiate with the anti-government protesters to let the election officials through, and then gunfire broke out with police and reporters trapped in the middle. They actually had to send in the army to try and pull the reporters and some policemen out of that gun battle. But it's been very indicative of the violence that's been going on here since this standoff began. Very guerrilla style tactics: go in, start a gun battle, and then withdraw. That shooting's now been finished now for about half an hour. Behind me last week, there was a major gun battle on this bridge, which then went away, as it were. So the situation's very tense for tomorrow. It is very, very difficult for all the people who live in Bangkok. It's very quiet on the streets. Today, the anti-government protest leader, Suthep, took a very big march through Chinatown on Chinese New Year to drum up support there. So he's been very obvious, saying that he doesn't want violence, he wants to stay out in the streets, he wants a massive picnic tomorrow to stop the voting. The Election Commission is certainly up against it for tomorrow. 28 constituencies have nobody to vote for, 16 have only one to vote for. Most of the constituencies in the south, most of the polling stations have no ballots and no people to man them. And here in Bangkok, the 50 election officials, 50 out of 50, resigned in the week and said they're not going to take the risk of manning those polling stations, some of which are in the street underneath flyovers. So a very tense situation here. Obviously, violence has begun. Convoys of men in black helmets, black flak jackets are said to be moving around in the streets. Voting opens at about 11 o'clock tonight, UK time, midnight UK time. But the likelihood of having any result from this election is very, very slim. The Election Commission has said there'll have to be repeat votes and repeat votes, because people won't be able to get to ballot boxes.